Which magazine could hardly have had a more modest beginning? It was born in this humble building in Bethnal Green, looking like this in 1957. Lord Young, or Michael Young as he then was the founder.
We had no money at all at the beginning. We took this garage because it was about the cheapest thing we can get. It cost us 10 shillings a week. We had no money at all to start with. We thought that on the very day that it was launched, which is, I suppose, 30 years ago or thereabouts, that we might possibly have some chance. There was a taxi rolled up just behind where you're standing now, and a man got out of it and said, I'm from Marks and Spencer's, and I want to take out 10 subscriptions, if it's possible, at 10 shillings each. So we had suddenly had £5 more than we had before. We thought if Marks and Spencer's going to support us in this munificent way, why, others might do so too.
They have 900,000 members today, a large research HQ at Harpenden, and an annual income of £30 million. Inside, the HQ looks like a cross between a discount warehouse and a laboratory. Washing machines, now costing about £250, were 66 when Which began, £480 at today's prices. An electric kettle, now about £18, cost £5 in 1957.
The volume of testing we do has gone up dramatically. Last year we tested over 1,200 different products. And the range of products which we test has also expanded.
They now also do tests for outside agencies. The World Bank is paying for these pumps to be checked for reliability for use in the Third World. A measure of Which's success is that nowadays their rooftop flag doesn't raise anybody's eyebrows. Simon Neave at the Consumer Association's Harpenden HQ.